Today on Real Garage, we're going to continue our detour off the Trans Am project to do some major surgery on TJ. While in the process of rebuilding the front axle and drive shaft, I found some bad rust holes in the bottom of the frame rails in between where the skid plate mounts. Now this type of repair is definitely intimidating, so I want to show you how I fix these. Basically, surgery includes cutting out the bottom of the frame along with some of the sides, and then welding in a replacement frame cap over the remaining frame. I'll be using the Spectrum 375 plasma cutter and Multimatic 220 AC/DC or a Millermatic 211 MIG welder for this repair. Some of my other supplies include weld through primer, some rust neutralizer, some rust neutralizing rubberized undercoat bed liner, and an assortment of grinders. We're definitely getting dirty on this job, and the Miller anti-fog face shield is really gonna come in handy. Warning, read and follow all labels and your owner's manuals. First, I'm grinding the paint and any surface rust off. Then take a chipping or body hammer and determine how much of the bottom frame is really rotting. My first cuts aren't that critical. I'm just cutting the bottom and about a quarter to a half inch up the sides. Then I'll determine how high I need to cut the sides to get back into some good metal, since it's really rusting from the inside out. The goal is to leave at least 1 inch of the side rails to weld to. I like to leave as much as possible. I'm setting the Spectrum plasma for 20 to 25 amps. With the bottom out of the way, I can mark out my final side cuts. And then plasma cut that cancer out. Now I clean up the cut area and remove any residual rust from inside the rails. In prep for welding, I finish grinding the paint off the side rails to the frame top. After fitting and modifying the new frame cap if needed, I spray the sides with weld through primer and coat the inside frame with the rust neutralizer. This type of injury happens on these Jeeps because there really isn't any drain holes on the bottom of the frame to let trapped water out. And I'm going to make sure that doesn't happen again. On my frame cap, I'm drilling 4 1-inch holes and then flaring them down like this one, instead of up into the frame. That will ensure water will drain instead of being pooled inside. Also, I'd punch a bunch of 3/8 plug weld holes in the sides, something most shops don't do, but it does add extra strength. Now that I know how far down the replacement cap will overlap the old frame, we'll take it outside to my paint booth and give it a coat of weld through primer, and then the lower inside area will be treated with the undercoat bed liner. I'll let this cure up overnight. Okay, this is what we have. Out with the old, slightly perforated frame, and in with the new. I've got my weld through primer on the overlap sides, and the rest is treated with that rubberized undercoat bed liner. I also make sure that I grind clean all my weld areas. Now the fun part, fitting this thing back in the Jeep, clamping it, and welding. I've got my Multimatic 220 AC/DC auto set for 1/8 inch using 030 Hobart ER70S6 wire. I'm tacking quite a few spots around the frame and then going back and hitting the plug welds. For all the outside seam welds, I'm skipping around putting down 1-inch welds until it's completely welded. One-inch stitch welds never look perfect. If this was a customer car, I'd probably smooth them out with a grinder. I'm just going to prime and paint. I'm also using the undercoating bed liner. Basically, it's do the same thing for the other side, except there's some brake and fuel lines that need to be repositioned before cutting. When reinstalling the skid plate, I used some spacer washers in between the frame to drop it about 1/4 inch below the drain holes I made to make sure that the water drains properly. Next time on Real Garage, we jump back on the Trans Am project. We ditch the rear package tray and make a new firewall.